So in the last video, we tried to test the mirror exposure effect, and many of you were kind enough to play along. Thank you. So what we did was we inserted a few shapes in the last video for a single frame. Some of you noticed, but most of you didn't, or at least you didn't tell us. We wanted to test a principle others have studied, which is that people can develop a preference for things they've been merely exposed to, but aren't aware they've been exposed to. There were two different shapes you saw in the video. One appeared once, and one appeared three times. So we asked if you preferred each of them to a shape you didn't see. We also added another question with two shapes you didn't see. All these shapes have been taken from previous studies, and they've been standardized, so that people, on average, don't report actually liking any of them more than any of the others when they see them for the first time. So when we asked you to choose between two that you hadn't seen before, we expected essentially random chance answers, close to 50-50. And that was basically what we saw. This result wasn't significantly different from 50%. For the shape that was only seen once, that was also not significantly different from chance, but it was at least slightly in the direction of preferring the one that was seen before. But 85% of people preferred the shape that was seen three times, which was well above the level of chance. Even we were surprised it was this many. We saw a similar pattern when we asked for ratings of how much you like each shape on its own. The shapes that appeared in the video were more liked than the shapes that didn't appear in the video, with a big exception of a pretty likable unpresented shape. So it seems we have, for a single data point at least, some evidence that the mirror exposure effect can work subliminally. What's interesting about this result is that it happened even during a video explaining exactly how the mirror exposure effect works. For example, we also asked a question about which cephalopod you prefer. The results were evenly split, even though only the octopus appeared in the video, and it appeared for a much longer time than any of the other shapes. Now, these shapes haven't been standardized the same way that the others were, so it's possible people did have some genuine preferences. But chances are that some people remembered that the octopus appeared, but didn't want to admit their behavior was predictable, so they chose the squid instead. But if that happened, far fewer people were able to use that same strategy with the shapes. This is an important thing to keep in mind as we learn about any predictable effect of human behavior. We often want to believe that we won't be susceptible to it and that we're the exception. But if we don't have our attention drawn to it, we're often just as susceptible as everyone else. It's good to keep some humility in mind about that. Now that being said, I wouldn't take the result of one subliminally preferred shape from a YouTube video and build extensive beliefs from it about how people work. For one thing, we only induced a preference for a single shape, and maybe despite all the past standardizing, there really is something more likable about this one. Ideally, we'd test several different shapes. Also, just how unusual is the result of 85% of people preferring one over the other? Not a whole lot of people took the survey. The statistical test on the difference between 85% and 50% provides a p-value of 0.006. That's kind of like getting heads on 7 coin tosses in a row, and then concluding that the coin isn't fair. Certainly a little unusual for a fair coin, but it's far from unheard of, and it's definitely not impossible. We'd want to replicate the experiment, and we might expect the preference to go down next time. So thank you for participating in this, and thank you for subscribing. Thanks also to John Corbin, who put together the survey and data and charts for this video. We'll have more videos coming up about how psychology and social science meet numbers and data and statistics, so stick around for more. And if you'd like to see a topic covered here, leave a message in the comments below. And also, thank you.